Hello viewers, this is Rajiv Bhumik. You are watching my channel Make Things Easy. Welcome to my channel. You will get lot of useful videos in my channel. So please subscribe my channel and watch this video till the end. Hello viewers, this topic is 7 QC drills. See, over the years, this topic, people think it is very difficult. It is not my cup of tea, but actually it is not so. After watching this video, you will find this topic is very easy and you can utilize all the 7 tools very easily. So please keep watching. First is check sheet. Second is cause and effect diagram. Third is control charts. Fourth is histogram. Fifth is Pareto chart. Sixth is scatter diagram. Seventh is stratification. To remember easily, you can call it as CCCHPSS. That means CCC means check, cause, control, CCC. HP is histogram and Pareto, HP, and scatter and stratification is SS. So CCCHPSS, you can remember it like this. See, these tools are required to solve problems. Suppose you are an engineer and there is a car breakdown. So you know all the tools very well. So you go nearby the car and you utilize the required tool to rectify that car. Kaoru Ishikawa developed 7 basic tools of quality so that the average person could analyze and interpret data. These tools have been used worldwide by companies, managers of all levels and employees. If you see my video, easily you can utilize any of the tools for any problem solving. Here we'll try to understand what is check sheet. A sheet designed in advance to allow easy collection and aggregation of data. By just entering check marks on a check sheet, data can be collected to extract necessary information, or a thorough inspection can be performed in an efficient manner, eliminating a possibility of skipping any of the required inspection items. Here we'll see one example. Here is a data date wise and defect wise. Vertical scratch, scratch, dent, and we can see total vertical scratch is 45 numbers, scratch is 24, dent is 32. So this is an example of check sheet. And this date wise data, that is, suppose you can see date 1 vertical scratch, so it is called tally mark, 4 horizontal line and 1 diagonal line, so that is 5, number 5. Another 4 horizontal line, 1 diagonal line, so that is 5 plus 5 10. So like this, if you add everything, it will come 45. So this kind of data is called tally mark. So this is an example of check sheet. Now we'll try to understand cause and effect diagram. A cause and effect diagram is also called as fishbone diagram, that presents a systematic representation of the relationship between the effect, that is result, and affecting factor, that is causes. Man, machine, method, materials. These 4 matters are considered as cause for any problem. Nowadays, few other parameters are also being added, like environment, etc. When any problem arises, interdepartmental employees meet together and draw a fishbone diagram and identify the actual root cause of that problem. So it looks like a fish, and people from different departments like production, quality, maintenance, purchase. So they sit together and they try to analyze all the causes, and they then find out the actual cause for that problem. Here we'll try to find out an example of fishbone diagram. There is a problem in a photocopying machine, and after analyzing everything, man, machine, material, method, it is identified that the too thin paper is the main reason for the problem. So you can see this is the example of a cause and effect diagram or fishbone diagram. Here we'll try to understand control chart. X bar R chart is one of the form of control chart. We'll try to understand how to make this chart. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 data is taken for some dimension, and 10 times consecutive 10 times it is taken. So total 50 data we have. Now we have to find out average, that is x bar. So average of 5 data, that is 6.546. So like this 10 average is taken. After that we have to note down maximum and minimum of that 5 data. So that is also taken. Now we have to do maximum minus minimum. So that is called range R. So the green line is R. So we got average, that is X bar, red line, and range R, that is green line. So up to here no issue. I think you have understood. Now we have to find out X double bar, R bar. X double bar is nothing but the average of the X bar, that is red line. And R bar means the average of R, that is the green line. So that is also we have found out. So up to here there is no issue. You have understood. Now the main thing, we have to find out the upper control limit X, lower control limit X, and upper control limit R, lower control limit R. For this there is a formula given, and we have find out the calculation also and the result also. Here one thing, there are some constant like A2, D3, D4. So this data is not here. So for that we have to refer a book, Industrial Engineering and Management by O.P. Khanna, page number 8.35. There you will find for sample size 5, A2, D3, D4 value is given. A2 is 0.58, D3 is 00, and D4 is 2.11. So like that you can calculate the upper control limit and lower control limit. Now see how to draw graph. So we have the X bar data that we have taken here, and we have draw a graph by upper control limit and lower control limit. Here we can see the data is within the range. It has not gone out of the range. So our process is under control. And for R range also we have to draw a graph. Here also we have used upper control limit, lower control limit, and we can see the data is within the range. So it shows that the process is under control. Now we'll try to understand what is histogram. Histogram can identify the location of the mean, that is central value or degree of variation. Now here we can see a histogram. Here most of the data will fall near the X bar, that is mean value, and some data will fall beyond the upper control limit and lower control limit, even though those data are within the tolerance, that is upper specified limit and lower specified limit of that dimension. But it is better to avoid those data, and you have to make your process in such way that most of the data should fall near the mean value. Then your process will be called as controlled process, capable process. So histogram will help us to find out whether my process is under control or not. Now we'll see what is Pareto chart. It is also called 80-20 chart. Here there is a scrap data of a company. Dimension wise rejection is 504.8 kg. Body mark wise rejection is 87.9 kg. So total scrap is 689 kg. Now we'll convert it into percentage. Like 4.8 divided by 689 into 100, that is 0.7%, and cumulative percentage incident is 73.27 plus 12.76 is equal to 86.02. 86.02 plus 9.11, it will come 95.14. So like this. So this chart is ready. Now we'll convert it into a graph. So graph shows like this. Now here two graph, one is the blue line, another is the black line. So here we'll convert it into 80-20 chart. We'll draw a red line at 80%. Now this red line and black line intersect in some point where we'll draw another line. So the arrow side percentage, this is the main reason for this scrap data. So we have to attack on dimension, why the dimension wise rejection is happening. So we have to reduce dimension wise rejection, then we can control the data. So like this Pareto chart, 80-20 chart, it will help us to reduce our wastage, our rejection. So it also calls that 80% rejection due to 20% reason. So I hope you have understood very easily. Now we'll try to understand what is scatter diagram. A scatter diagram is used to examine the relationship between two paired interrelated data types, such as height and weight of a person. A scatter diagram provides a means to find whether or not these two data types are interrelated. It is also utilized to determine how closely they are related to identify a problem point that should be controlled or improved. Now we'll see some example. For example, there is a relationship where an increase in the number of rotation, that is in x-axis, causes an increase in aberration, that is in y-axis. There is a positive correlation. So this is called positive correlation. Now we'll see the vice versa. If, on the other hand, existence of a relationship where an increase in the number of rotations, that is in x-axis, causes a decline in aberration, that is in y-axis, that is called negative correlation. So friends, I hope you have understood. Now we'll try to understand what is stratification. Stratification means to divide the whole data into smaller portion according to certain criteria. Stratification generally means to divide data into several groups to find out a cause for a defect. Now we'll see one example. Suppose scratch mark is coming in finished goods. So this is a problem, and we'll try to find out solution or the root cause through stratification. So we'll take 1 week data. Suppose there are three shift, morning shift, evening shift, night shift. So we'll take three shift data. Then there are three operator. We'll take three operators data, operator X, operator Y, operator Z. Then we'll take three machines data. Suppose there are three machines. So we'll take machine 1, machine 2, machine 3's data. So after taking all the data and analyzing everything, we can find out some solution. So like this, in this case, we have find out that in the night shift, operator X and machine 2, there is some issue. That's why this scratch mark is coming in finished goods. So now we know the reason. So now we can implement some action so that this problem can be eliminated. Now here we'll try to understand application of 7QC tools in problem solving. Identification of problem, we can use Pareto diagram. Defining the problem, we can use check sheet, stratification, Pareto diagram, and sometimes histogram. Record of fact, we can use check sheet, stratification, histogram, control chart. Detecting causes of problem, we can use cause and effect diagram, histogram, scatter diagram, and sometimes stratification. Develop improvement method, that is solution. 7QC tools are not usable in this. Implementation. Here also 7QC tools are not usable. Evaluation of result. Here we can use cause and effect diagram, histogram, scatter diagram, and sometimes stratification also can be used. Process control, that is standardization. Control charts are used. Here we will try to sum up the usage of 7QC tools. Check sheet to record data collection. Cause and effect diagram to identify the cause and effect relationship. Control charts or graph to find the trend of data, UCL versus LCL. Histogram to see the distribution of data. Pareto diagram to identify the current status and issues, that is through 80-20 ratio. Stratification, basic processing performed when collecting data. Scatter diagram to identify the relationship between two things. So I hope you have understood 7QC tools very easily. So viewers, thanks for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video. If you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe it and like this video, share this video. And if you want to comment some things, please leave your comment in the comment section. Thank you once again for watching this video.